Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 13.4 Beta 2 has been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro Max like I normally do, along with my 12.9-inch iPad Pro from 2018. Now, I have used it on older devices as well, and I've gathered a bunch of information from you based off the YouTube community poll. So I'll go through that in a little bit, but the first thing is I want to talk about my experience, then your experience, then we'll take a little bit of a look at the YouTube community polls. But first, before we do any of that, there's a couple new little things that I didn't mention in my update video. And most of these things are not something I would necessarily mention, but there's quite a few little tweaks and changes that they've made, so I thought I'd just pass them on. So the first thing is, in wallpapers, they've moved this icon. And normally I don't cover a lot of the icon changes and things like that, but the little icon here used to be off to the side, now it's in the center. Now, also in settings, let's go back here. If we go to Safari settings and then go down to experimental features, which is under advanced, you'll see experimental features. They've added about 10 or so more experimental features. And so these are all turned on by default. I did not turn on any of these, but there's different things that you can turn on if you want to try them out. And CSS typed OM, capture video in UI process. A lot of this is for developers or for people developing different things for the web, things like that. So if you want to try them out, they're there. Now, another small change, for example, let me go over to files. They've tweaked this little icon in the upper right. And the reason I don't cover a lot of these little small icon changes is because Apple will tweak it again, most likely before the final release. So a lot of the time they'll change the icon, they'll change it again, and then they'll change it a third or fourth time. And so there's changes throughout the UI like that, just small little tweaks. It could be one pixel, it could be many pixels, or a complete redesign. If it's major, I'll go over it though. But one of the things they have been updating quite a bit is Find My. So if you use Find My, we'll go into that. And if you use Find My, a lot of these icons have been changed. So some of the different icons have just been updated all over the place. So under some, there's different share icons and all sorts of things. So if you go into that and you're on beta 2, you'll see slight tweaks. And I think that's because they're going to be coming out with AirTags, or at least showing it soon. And that's where you can locate devices that you can place in things like your backpack to help locate them. So you'll see lots of those little tweaks and changes, but most of the major changes that I mentioned in the follow-up video are the things they've put in this beta. Now, I would expect a new beta either this coming week, or we could be on that 2-week cycle at this point. It's hard to say, but let's go over some of the experiences I've had. And the first thing you might be noticing is I'm not using the stock email app, and I've been trying other email apps. This one's Spark, but I've been trying other ones because, well, today all of a sudden my email shut off. I couldn't get my email on my iPhone. I went on my Mac and it was there. So I was kind of strange. I went back into my settings and turned it on, but I've been having all sorts of weird issues with mail, and I want to make sure that I receive it. So I've been trying different email apps. I actually like the stock email app a lot, but I've been trying other ones. I've tried Outlook and Spark and Edison and all sorts of them, but I really want it to be private and secure as well. Now, one of the other issues I've experienced a couple times is settings locking up. So if I'm in the main settings page here, sometimes it will freeze. Now, we had this earlier on with iOS 13, but it seems like it's back. So I have been having that here and there. And other than mail and that, I had one other issue that I've been experiencing regularly, and that is with rotation, but on the iPad. Now, on the 12.9 iPad Pro, I'd have a lot of weird issues with rotation. I'd have to turn the display off, turn it back on. I haven't had to reboot it yet, but I saw this issue when I was showing it on the iPhone 8 Plus when I was rotating the display. It just wasn't working right. So there's definitely something going on with rotation. Quite a few of you have told me the same thing. So it's an ongoing problem and seems to be something that's showing up for a lot of people. Now, there's some issues that quite a few of you have been having as well. Most of you are mentioning things like settings locking up or messages not working properly. Messages may not send properly, or it won't show the icons for some users. So there's lots of little weird issues with messages. Thankfully, I don't think I've seen too many of them other than within group texts and trying to send between your iPhone and your Mac if you have those linked. So those are the only areas I've seemed to have those issues with, and that hasn't really been much of an issue. Also, I've had no issues with LTE or Wi-Fi connectivity, thankfully. Everything seems to be fast switching between Wi-Fi and LTE, so it seems that problem for me is fixed, although a few of you have said that you've had that issue still. So it's still hanging out there, and it doesn't seem to be dependent on which carrier you're using. So if you're using T-Mobile like I am or another carrier, it seems to be dependent on something else. And that is really it for issues people have been mentioning. Those were the number one issues people mentioned, but most people mentioned that performance seemed to be about the same, and then battery life was about the same. And I've experienced pretty much the same battery life as Beta 1. Most people are saying Beta 1 and Beta 2 are better battery than iOS 13.3.1. So if we go into my battery here, my battery health is at 100%. And like I've said before, the updates don't really affect this, they just measure it. But let's go back to my last 10 days and we'll take a look at, I guess we'll take a look at today. So I've had 2 hours and 40 minutes of screen on time, 4 minutes of screen off time. So not a whole lot of usage today. That's because it's a weekend and I'm primarily using this iPad. So let's go back a few days. And the most used day was 4 hours and 26 minutes of screen on time, 2 hours and 18 minutes of screen off time. And that was using about 50% of my battery. So that day I'd probably get, if I used it to 100%, double that, I'd probably get about 9 hours of screen on time. And generally I'm seeing about 10 to 12. It just depends on the day. And screen off time is a lot. That's using the phone with music and things like that, just with headphones or AirPods. So overall, it's been pretty good. There have been a couple complaints of speed, but for the most part, that was mostly on iPhone 7s for some reason. Other than that, most people are having no problems. Now, RAM management has been fine, and no one mentioned that it was a problem in the community poll, only positive things. In fact, here are all the major issues mentioned based off all the stats that I do every week, and then here's all the devices that people mentioned if they mentioned which device they're using in the comments. So in general, RAM management seems to be doing fine, and most issues were related around battery, but most people said it was fine. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now I put this poll live only 12 hours ago since I wanted to give time for public beta testers to actually use it, and you'll see I had 5.1K votes. So that's actually a little bit lower than normal, but I think that's because interest in the betas has gone down as people anticipate iOS 14 being shown in June, and we're either sick of betas or you're using iOS just more stably, or you want to use an older version. And so 15% of you said that it was great, 2% said it was terrible, 5% said okay, but some bugs, 62% of you are on older versions, such as iOS 13.3.1 or older, and 15% of you are using Android. So that seems to be a pretty consistent number, so thanks again for voting if you're using Android, even though this doesn't pertain to you. So let me go ahead and sort the 103 comments. I've read them all, and again, that's where I got all the information for this video. But let's take a look at what you had to say. So the first comment says, great for me so far on my iPhone XS. The next one said, I have only one bug on my 5th gen iPad, the weird rotation lock thing. Everything else has been great. Same rotation lock bug I mentioned earlier. And then let's take a look at some others. I get this weird bug in Safari. When I open it fresh and start typing in the address bar, it'll freeze for 5 to 10 seconds before doing anything again. Few app crashes on my iPhone 11 Pro Max. Battery life seems to be the best I've had. The performance is good, but auto rotation problem is still not fixed, and it's really annoying. RAM management is okay. iPhone 7 Plus user. Settings crashes to home screen often, but that's the only glitch I noticed so far. XS Max. iPhone 10 on 13.4 Beta 2, when I open Safari and tap the address bar and start typing, it would freeze for about 5 seconds or so. Otherwise, everything is great. iPhone 11 Pro Max on iOS 13.4 Beta 2, one bug I've noticed is that I can't rotate into landscape in first-party applications like settings, maps, weather, etc. I have the rotation lock turned off and it won't rotate in the apps. Otherwise, performance and battery are great. I'm on the iPhone XR and the battery does not last long with this update. iMessage freezes for 10 to 30 seconds, then populates the personal photo image and begins to work correctly. iPhone XS never happened prior. iPhone 11 Pro, great battery life and no bugs worth mentioning. I have iPhone 11. I don't know what happened after the update. My PUBG gameplay feels choppy, even though the settings are in extreme, which should give 60 frames per second, but I'm only getting 30 frames per second. It used to work as it should when it was on prior versions. Can someone explain this? Is the update making a frame per second? It could be because it's a beta. If you're on that beta, there definitely can be issues. So if you really rely on playing that game, for example, you may not want to use a beta. Using an iPhone 11, no real issues to complain about except occasional rotation ones. Battery's great, RAM management great, speed smooth and fast. Apps are working correctly, so overall, great. I have this bug where every time I type, the words will always show up as an uppercase, but then I type and it's lowercase. It's amazing on my 10S, battery life is better than Beta 1. Working good on 6S, still having an issue with starting the second line of text in the message. The first word doesn't show up until the second word is typed out. Kinda hard to know if it's typing or not on that line. Really good, but some bugs. Pro Max and iPad Pro. Pro Max screen on is not great for the first time. Still early on though. My main iPad issue is my Apple Pencil stops writing multiple times a day and I have to forget it and reconnect it to make it work. And I think you asked me on that on Twitter as well, and you're the only person I've actually had mentioned that there's issues with the Apple Pencil. I'm using an iPhone 6S Plus, and I can tell that the battery is way better than the first beta. I can also see that there are less app crashes and bugs, and I don't have a problem with the auto rotation. And that's it for the comments, and that's pretty much it for this beta. I'm not sure, like I said earlier, if we're on a 1 or 2 week schedule, but if we're on a 1 week schedule, I would expect that the next beta would be probably Wednesday if they're going to continue doing every week, just like we had this week, or they're going to push it until, say, the 4th of March, and then we'll see the final probably at the end of March, around the time that we see that next Apple event, where they'll show probably some new things like a new Apple TV. Some of these things have leaked in some Target information from the store Target, where we actually saw some inventory leaks where they didn't give names per se, but they saw updated inventory popping up in their system regarding Apple TV and iPod touches and other things. So it'll be interesting to see what we see and whether or not Apple will actually do an event or just push these things out in on their website or something like that. But let me know what you think about this update in the comments below. And also, I think most people are just looking forward to iOS 14, or they want to modify their phones and play around with them with iOS 13.3 or older. But let me know what you think in the comments below. I'll leave a link to this wallpaper in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.